Hi students, welcome to maths class. We have finished up to question number 12. Now we'll see question number 13. So here, one interesting thing to understand that how to find out the area of the shaded region. Here in question number 13, so if we can cut off the area of this square, it is told here OABC is a square. And O, P, B, Q is a sector. Then from the area of the sector, if we can cut off the area of the square, then we will get the area of the shaded region. So remember that here given side of the square, OA is given 20 cm, that is the side of the square, it is not the radius of the sector. So to find out the area of the sector, we need the radius. So radius is unknown. So we need to find out the radius of this sector. Then we will join here OB. OB is going to be the radius of the sector. And for the square we say this is diagonal. So diagonal of a square formula is root 2 into side. Then diagonal we will get, that is going to be the radius for the sector. So first we have to take out the length OB, that is the diagonal for the square and radius for the sector. So it is being a square, this is one right triangle. So diagonal OB is equal to root 2 into side. Root 2 into side, that is A. Then root 2 into side of the square is given 20 centimeter. So this is 20 root 2 centimeter. So it is the radius of the sector. Now we'll cut off the area of square from the area of the sector to get the area of the shaded region. Therefore, diagonal we are getting, that is going to be the radius of the sector. Therefore, radius of the sector, radius R is going to be 20 root 2 centimeter. Therefore, area of the shaded region is equal to area of the entire sector, that is theta by 360 pi r square minus area of square is side square. Then it is being square, OABC is a square, so each angle is going to be 90 degree. So sector angle is 90 divided by 360. Pi value is given, that is 3.14 into radius square. This is 20 root 2 into 20 root 2 minus side square. Then side of the square is given, that is 20. Then 20 into 20. This much centimeter square is the area of the shaded region. Now 0 cancel, 9, 4, 36, again cancellation by 4, 4, 1, 4, 5, now multiply it, getting 5 into 20, 100, then 100 root 2 into root 2, 2, then 100 into 2, 200, then 200 into 314, then 314 into 2, then 2, 4, 8, 2, 1, 2, 2, 3, 6, and 2 more zeros, decimal before 2 digits. Zeros go minus 200, 20, 20, 400. So this much centimeter square, then 628 minus 400. 6 minus 4 is 2, 2, 8 centimeter square. So this is the area of the shaded region. I hope you all are understanding it. Area of the entire sector minus area of the square is going to be the area of the shaded region. And to find out the area of the sector, radius was unknown. So radius finding by finding the diagonal of the square. Diagonal of the square is going to be the radius of the sector. Read question number 14. and see the figure. A, B and C, D are the arcs of two concentric circles. So here A, B and C, D, these two are the arcs of two concentric circles with center O. So here radius of the bigger sector, that is 21 cm, and radius of the smaller sector is 7 cm, and sector angle is 30 degrees. So we need to find out the area of the shaded region. To get the area of shaded region, it is very clear that area of bigger sector minus area of the smaller sector is going to be the area of the shaded region. Then to get the area of bigger sector, bigger radius, that is 21 cm. To find out the area of the smaller sector, radius of the smaller sector, that is 7. So, and sector angle for both the sectors, that is 30 degree. So here sector angle theta is 30 degree and bigger radius is 21 centimeter and smaller means the radius of the smaller sector is 7 centimeter. Now to get the area of the shaded region, area of bigger sector minus area of smaller sector. Therefore the area of the shaded region, area of the shaded region is area of bigger sector minus area of smaller sector. Area of bigger sector, that is theta by 360 pi r square. Bigger radius, capital R is used here, minus area of smaller sector, that is theta by 360 pi small r square. So here we are finding theta by 360 pi common in both cases. Then theta by 360 pi taking common, capital R square minus small r square. Now we will place the values. Then theta is given 30 degree by 360 into value of pi is not given, that is 22 by 7. Capital R, radius of the bigger sector 21 square minus radius of the smaller sector is 7. This is 7 square. So this much centimeter square. 0, 0 cancel, 3, 12, 36, again by 2 cancel, 2, 6, 2, 11, so getting 11 by 6 into 7, and here 21 square, 21, 441, minus 7, 7, 49 centimeter square. Now we will calculate it. Then 11 by 6 into 7, into 9 plus 2, 11, 1 getting 4 plus 1, 5, then 5 plus 9, 14, 1 getting, then 4 minus 1, 3, 392 centimeter square. Now cancellation by 7, 7, 5, 35, 4 left, 7, 6, now cancellation by 2, 2, 3, to 28, then 28 into 11, 28 into 11, then 8 to 308 divided by 3 centimeter square. So this is the area of the shaded region. I hope you all are understanding area of shaded region, how we are getting. Now area of the bigger sector minus area of the smaller sector. And to find out the area of sector, we need two things, that is sector angle and radius. Both are given here. Let's see question number 15. So here it is given ABC is a right triangle and ACB, this is one sector. And BC as diameter, one semicircle is drawn. Then BC is the diameter of the semicircle. So here our work is to find out the area of the shaded region. Then how will I find out the area of shaded region? Now first we need to get the area of this part. Then name this middle part as P. Then BCP, area of this BCP, if we get, we will subtract from the area of semicircle, that is going to be the area of the shaded region. And to get the area of BCP, this part, Then area of the circle minus area of the right triangle. Area of right triangle half into base into height side of this triangle is given 14 centimeter. So this is the radius of the circle. Then we need to get the hypotenuse of the right triangle, which is going to be the diameter of the semicircle, bigger semicircle. So area of BCP will be area of circle. In this case, radius is 14 and angle is 90 degree. Then area of circle minus area of triangle is going to be BCP. After that, we need to get the diameter of the semicircle. Now, area of BCP is equal to area of the sector theta by 360 pi r square minus area of right triangle we will cut off from this sector, we will get this BCP, this region. That is half into base into height. Then it is being right triangle 90 degree by 360. Value of pi is given or not, just check. Value of pi is not given here. So value of pi will take 22 by 7 into radius, 14 into 14, minus half into base. Base of the right triangle 14, height is also 14 centimeter square. Now 2, 7 is 14, so here 0 cancelled, 9, 4 is 36. Now cancellation by 2, 2, 2 is 4, 2, 7 is again 2. 27 ya. Now getting 7 ya 49. Again one more 7 cancel. 7 cancel. Then 22 7 ya 154 minus 74 ya 28. 2 71 ya 7 plus 2 9 centimeter square. So 8 plus 6 14. 1 carrying 10. Then 15 minus 10 is 5, 56 centimeter square. This is the area of which part? Now only BCP, this region, area of this region we have got. Then area of this region, if we subtract from the area of semicircle, then we will get the area of the shaded region. And to find out the area of the semicircle, we need to get the diameter BC. Then BC will be the hypotenuse of this right triangle ACB. Then BC, hypotenuse square equal to perpendicular square plus base square, that we know. This is Pythagoras theorem, PG theorem. Then BC is equal to square root of AB 14 square plus AC is also 14 centimeter. Then BC is equal to square root of 14 square plus 14 square, that is 2 into 14 square. Like a square plus a square, 2a square. So here 14 square plus 14 square is 2 into 14 square. So here 114 will come out and root 2 centimeter. BC is the diameter of the semicircle. So we will get the radius. Therefore the radius of the semicircle, that is capital R, before we have used here small r. So radius of the bigger semicircle, that is 14 root 2 by 2 centimeter. So this is 7 root 2. This is 7 root 2 centimeter. This is the radius of the biggest semicircle. Now we'll subtract the area of 56 from the area of the semicircle. Therefore, the area of shaded region half pi r square. Pi r square is the area of circle, that is why area of semicircle is half pi r square minus from the semicircle this part BCP cut off. Area of BCP we are keeping ready, that is 56 centimeter square. It's much centimeter square. Now half into value of pi 22 by 7 into radius of the bigger semicircle, that is 7 root 2. 7 root 2 into 7 root 2 minus 56 centimeter square. Now 7 cancelled, and 2 11 ja, getting how much? Now 7 11 ja 77, 77 into root 2 into root 2, 2. Then 77 into 2, 77 into 2, 154 minus 56 centimeter square. So we are getting 8 plus 6, 14, 1 getting 6, 9 minus 6, 15 minus 6 is 9 centimeter square. So this is the area of the shaded region. So here directly we cannot go to the area of this shaded region. First we are finding out the area of this part, that is BCP, by subtracting the area of right triangle from the area of sector. Now after that we are getting the diagonal BC to get the radius of the smaller circle, to get the radius of the semicircle. Now after getting diameter we are making half to get radius. And from the area of semicircle, we will cut off the area of BCP to get the area of the shaded region. So, okay, thank you students for watching and learning. We'll meet you in the next class.